Welcome to Stationery HQ, where you design, we deliver. In this tutorial, we'll cover how to properly set up your PDF in accordance to our guidelines, which can be found here in our File Setup Guidelines page. For this tutorial, we'll use the A7 Foldover card. Go to the top menu, hover over Products, and select Folded Cards. From here, scroll down to the Folded Cards section and click on A7 Foldover card. By default, this product page displays the A7 foldover in the landscape orientation. For this tutorial, we'll be using the portrait orientation, so let's change this drop-down selection to portrait. The preview area now shows the artwork size to be 7.25 inches by 10.25 inches, trimming down to the final size of 7 inches by 10 inches. We will need to keep this in mind while we finalize our artwork file for print. Now let's start with an example using Adobe Photoshop. We finished our lovely masterpiece and are ready to send it over for print. Before we do anything else, let's make sure our piece is as print ready as possible. First, let's check to make sure that the file has the right dimensions. Go to the navigation bar, select Image and Canvas Size. A dialog box appears and we see that the dimensions are currently 3075 pixels by 2175 pixels, which isn't super helpful for us right now. Let's change it to inches. The window shows that the file is currently 10.25 inches by 7.25 inches. We're looking to create a folded A7 card, which requires an artwork size of 10.25 inches in width and 7.25 inches in height, trimming to a final size of 10 inches by 7 inches. This then folds to 5 inches by 7 inches. This is exactly what we want. Next, as you can see in the Layers tab, we have two layers with type. To help ensure that the text is printed exactly as we want it, let's right-click and select Convert to Shape, which converts the text into an outlined object. We'll do the same with the other type layer. Quick note here that if you're using an image in your file, remember to use a high-quality image of at least 300 pixels per inch. Our file looks good to go, so let's save it as a PDF. Go to the navigation bar, select File, and Save As. Navigate to where you'd like to save your PDF. Once you're in your desired folder, select Photoshop PDF in the drop-down menu. We want to continue to use the working CMYK setup, but we also want to remove the ICC profile. Click Save. A pop-up may appear for you notifying you that you can override your settings in the next dialog box, which is fine. Click OK. In the Save Adobe PDF dialog box, we want to select the PDF X1A preset. All other settings look good, so we'll click Save PDF. From there, let's upload the file onto the Stationery HQ website. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing Stationery HQ.